on Amazon. Dr. Kumar Sir has developed content for a number of educational institutes of national repute. He is also the key person behind India's leading testing portal, TuTOP. Now, without a delay, I would like to invite Dr. Pankaj Kumar Sir to kindly enlighten the young mind with his words of wisdom.
Thank you for introducing me. So first of all, let me ask to the parents that I'm audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So once again, I welcome all of you on behalf of Team DYP. So my all staffs, the major faculty members are also in the sessions. So I'm just going to give you a brief presentation that what the DYP is and what are the futures as far as the competitive exams is concerned and how to prepare it. So these are the things what we are going to speak about. So once I will finish the presentation, then definitely we will be talking about your queries, about your doubts. And I request all parents to make this interaction absolutely interactive. So definitely we would like to just take this particular opportunities to have a very good interactions. So once again, I welcome parents and I'm very thankful that they have taken out time for this webinar. So first of all, DY Patil Academy, that is a well-known institute in the test prep courses. So we have started journey in 2019. So from that standard, we are just 4 years old. Of course, in these 4 years, we have also faced the 2 years of the COVID things as well. So you see, as you know, this academy is a part of well-known DY Patil Group, which is known for its academic excellence. And you are also part of it. So we all know that how passionate we are for the education things. But as far as the academy is concerned, so I think we are the only the group in which the academy is present. So currently we are located at Pune, Kolhapur, Tasgaon, Gargoti, Palouse, Islampur, Wagholi. So these are the area where currently we are operating. So we have a full-fledged center over there, this entire regions. And of course, the head office is in Pune. So what I assume that or whatever what information I have, that all the parents are of science. So all are in class 11. So the first thing I must say that all of you have taken a very best option. I must congratulate you. So science is the best option because after 10th, you see there are three options are open. That is, the student can go for arts or commerce or science. But of course, the science is the best option. Now, why science is the best option? Because you see, it always going to offer you more career opportunities in terms of rest of the two streams. Okay, I don't want to emphasize on that since you have already taken decision, right? So just I want to put the thing in correct perspective, because you see, there are two well-known fields, right? One is the engineering and second is the need, that is the medical. These are two are the well-known or well accepted the career fields. Now, apart from this, there are some other things also that also I'm going to discuss with you. But let me first of all just zero down these two major the career options. You know, every year there is a good 1 lakh seats available for various engineering courses, right? And this 1 lakh, I'm including the IITs, I'm including the NITs, right? I'm not including the all the other. So many colleges, engineering colleges that are available in Maharashtra, Karnataka and other cities. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about good engineering college in which the moment you pass your fourth year, then there is going to have a good campus. And after good campus, there is going to have a good placements, right? I'm talking about those. So altogether, there is a 1 lakh good seats available. Similarly, if you talk about MBBS, then we have around about 70,000 good seats that is available in case of MBBS. Now, you see, What is the total number of students who used to appear in this competitive exam? The total number is round about 12 to 13 lakhs. I must want to put the word only, 12 to 13 lakhs only. Why I'm putting only? Because you see, out of this 12 to 13 lakhs, 60% appear just for the sake of appearing. They do not prepare. So their job is just to fill the form, right? But whatever the other things that is required for actual preparation, that is missing. So actual competition is just between 4 to 5 lakhs. And out of 4 to 5 lakhs, you see, 1 lakh is a good seat. So simple mathematics is saying that every fifth or sixth student who is actually seriously preparing have a very, very fair chance to get in these good seats. So is the case of the MBBS. So I'm sure in this session, the students are also there. So students, please wake up. So first of all, we need to get out of this mindset that these exams are tough. No, exams are very easy, I'm telling you. Okay, competition is tough, right? Exams are easy. Questions are tough, but it is easier to make it given these conditions, right? I'm sure all of you agree that given the total number of students that is actually preparing, the chances of selections in both the engineering as well as the medical is very, very good, right? Let's move ahead. Let's talk about, as I told you, that I'm also going to speak about some other courses also, because not only engineering and medical, there are some other courses also, right? So I hope that all of you are aware about. If not, let me know. We will speak about that. So majorly, you see, these are the openings. You know, needless to talk about the IIT, JEE, NEET, no need. But there are a few very, very good exam. One is a KVPY, that is a Kishore Vaigyanik Protsahan Yojana. So this particular exam is actually for class 11 student as well as the class 12 students. And here what happens, once you qualify, the government is going to give you rupees 5,000 per month scholarship till you finish your educations. And once you reach, let it be say for postgraduates, then your scholarship amount is going to increase from 5,000 to 7,000 per month. That is the award, or that is the recognition what the government gives. Now, recognition is one part. But you see, this exemption is also going to open a number of gateway for you. There are a number of prestigious institutes in India who used to take admission only through KVPY. For instance, take an example of ICER. ICER used to take admission through the KVPY. Well, KVPY is not the only route. When I will come to the ICER, then I will speak about that. Then Indian Institute of Science, they also offer courses. Indian Space Organization, they also offer courses, right? So these are the areas where you can enter through two way. One, you should have a good rank in IIT JEE Advanced, number one. And number two, the KVPY. Either of these two is going to give you, open your gateway for these well-reputed organizations of India. So this is about the KVPY. Now, let's talk about the ICER. That is, you know, all those students who are interested in making career in science, in making career in research. This is an ideal institute in entire India. Institute of repute. They have a couple of centers. The main center is in Pune, but they also have a center in Calcutta, right? They have a center in MP also. Okay, but the major center is in Pune only. So there are three possible ways through which you can enter into ICER. One, getting good score in IIT JEE Advanced. It has been observed that if you are having an advanced rank up till below 10,000, then you can get direct entry, or you qualify a KVPY, or they also conduct a individual exam. Okay, in the individual exam, you have to appear for all the four subjects, that is physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology, right? Each subject having 15 questions, okay? And once you qualify, depending upon the rank, you are given the different the centers. So they offer a 5-year dual degree course. So once you qualify from here, then definitely you have a postgraduate degree with you. The most important thing is that they have excellent placements. So once you clear the postgraduate, right? So you will having a number of opportunities in the Institute of Repute, not only in India, but abroad also. So these are the very good opportunities what the ICER offers. CET, you know, the CET is this is an entrance test that is being conducted by the government of Maharashtra and for all the engineering college and the pharmacy. If you want to make a career in the pharmacy, then you can go through the CET. So there are a number of good pharmacy college also. So including DYP is also known for a very good pharmacy outings, right? So you can in the different cities. So we have a pharmacy college. So in those pharmacy college also, you can enroll after having a good marks in CET. And finally, one is ICAR. Suppose you want to make a career in agriculture. That is Indian Council of Agriculture Research. So they conduct a separate exam, right? So there are different agriculture universities across India. So they conduct a common test. On that particular test, depending upon your rank, so you are allocated the different cities where the different agricultural colleges are there. So these are the general opening as far as the science is concerned. Now let's talk about that. All of you are now in class 11, what to do, how to go about. Okay, so that is the main question. That is why we assemble over here. Okay. So first, if in the entire presentation we skip this particular things, then the presentation will remain not complete in itself. So the need of the hour is to align ourselves to the new normal. And we don't know that today we have a Omicron, next day what will come, we don't know, right? And unfortunately, this situation is going to continue. And at least it seems that few more years we have to live with it. So this COVID situation has definitely, but I also say they have also opened excellent opportunities for students as well. Excellent opportunities. Now, why I'm saying, you see, prior to COVID, have you seen the very popularity of the online education? No, nobody was actually aware about that. Now, this online education has opened an excellent opportunity regarding availability of the quality content, which otherwise it is not possible. No, it has its own challenges. Yes, because I am also interacting with a number of parents, and the parents are saying that the students are not very focused and they are losing focus. So the live classes is much better than the online classes. I do agree. I am with them, right? But you see, this system has given you something extra which was otherwise not possible even in the live class. Because you see, I can give you, suppose there is a one faculty who has an experience of, let it be, say, 40 years, and he has been teaching, he has been guiding his students, and every year at least 15 to 20 students score a top rank, those who are taught by him. Is it possible to make his service available to across the different students? No, not possible. If I ask him to please come to Navi Mumbai and teach the student, he will. Actually, probably he don't have a time. But by the online facility, definitely it can be, we can do it. Second most important thing, you see, competition is an art of rationalization of the resources. And one of the important resources is your time. Yes, time is the resource. So how importantly you allocate the time, that is very important. This new normal has certainly given you an opportunity to increase the quality time for a study. So students, you need to wake up. Because earlier what happens, you have to go to certain institutes. A quality time is going to be wasted in the commutation. That is not there. So definitely you can do it. One another thing is that, you see, to face the new normal, what we should do? The solution lies in the integrated courses. That is the one of the best solutions. Because you see, as a teacher, I'm telling you that the live class is equally important, or rather it is more important than the online classes. That I agree. Through online, we can just simply add on the important things, which earlier it was not popular, but now the new COVID situation has given another opportunity to mix and match and make a perfect hybrid solution for the students. Now, I was just speaking about the optimization of the resources. So in case of integrated course, there is a possibility for the optimization of the resources where the students are coming and simultaneously they are being taught for their board exam as well as the competitive exams. That is what the integrated course is all about. So here what happens? That coaching for one particular course, let it be say GE or NEET, that is going to happen simultaneously along with the board study, and that is under one roof. So the very advantage is that students are not going to waste time in accommodation. And second, the quality is also going to be ensured, because you are a part of a very reputed name. So definitely this name itself is going to take control of the quality aspects. So they will not compromise on the quality. So that is the most important thing, or most important deliverables in case of the integrated course. So I want to conclude this entire thing by simply saying that it is going to give you a time for self-study, and also it will ensure the qualitative academic delivery, which is eventually required for competitive success. So this is all about the integrated courses. Definitely, I would like to take all questions in the question answer sessions regarding if you have any doubts, any questions that how actually it is going to be operated. But let me give you a brief idea. So how actually we do? First of all, we focus on the core subjects. So for competition, you see, physics, chemistry, biology is a core for NEET. Physics, chemistry, mathematics is a core for engineering. So these core subjects are taught 4 days in a week. And 1 day is kept for other subjects, languages and practicals. And 1 day is actually kept for test and doubt sessions. So all these things will be done in consultation with the school regarding that how they are placed, how their courses is going to progress. So obviously the advantage is that the students need not require to bother about giving some extra time for preparing for the board, because that is going in place hand in hand. So competitive preparation and board, both are being taken care of. So this is a brief about the integrated course. So we are a part of DY Patil. So I don't want to throw light on this. We all aware about that, and even all parents are aware about Dada's contribution in the field of education. So institute or academy is also a part of Dada's visions. So currently we are working under the guidance of Honorable Minister of State, Mr. Satej Patil. So we are working under him. So it is his vision that he initiated the very process in the test prep courses like IIT, JEE, NEET also. Now, let me give you brief about the team DYP, that who we are. Because you see, basically, it is the teachers that is going to make it. So first of all, myself, so I've done PhD in life sciences. I was a CSIR fellow. So these are some of the ranks which I've mentioned in the last 2 to 3 years of my teaching. Now, we have our academic director, Dr. Vidya Manohar Sarma. So he was also CSIR fellow. So he has been teaching for the last 33 years, and he's a mentor, not only for the students, but for the teachers as well. Now, these are the other team members. So I have mentioned the team members of only Pune. So Mr. Devin Chandrakar, Mr. Suman Prakash, Professor Jagdish Patil, Professor Rajkumar Singh, Professor Nagendra Yadav, Professor Sasikant Survasay. So all these teachers are currently with us and they are teaching, they are delivering the services at the Pune Center. Now you may ask that whether these teachers are going to teach you. That is the obvious question, right? But let me tell you that once we will start the operation over there, then we have a separate team. Of course, the guidance, definitely, everything is will be working under the Pune. So the guidance will be definitely with us, from us, but we will be separately recruiting the faculty. So the faculty recruitment in our case is a very, very stringent process. So we don't compromise, right? And that is why in a very short span of time, just 3 years, we have been able to produce significant results. So these are the deliverables which we proposed, that 650 hours of academic delivery. So we are also going to give you the study materials. So we have our own testing portals because, you know, nowadays the exams are happen online. So what we do, weekly test is a part of our academic deliberations. So we have a test, we have our own testing portals. And we do conduct crash course once the board exam is over. And definitely the online test series, which is a continuous part of our academic deliberations. So these are the beef deliverables which I spoke about. Now let's talk about our results. So these are our top performer. Let me add over, I'm very proud to share that 21.2% of classroom program, right? I'm not talking about that some postal program or some students who have come in other courses. I'm not talking about, this is purely 2 year course. So in the 2 year course, 21.2% of the classroom program succeeded with a top percentile of 99.71 in JEE. So that is our results in case of JEE. Now this is the CET results. So we have excellent CET results. So you can figure it out with the percentage. So all the percentile is more than 91. Actually in CET, you see, we generally don't keep the record because almost all students, right? Because all engineering students are going to write the CET as well. And our observation is that more than 70% of students score 80 percentile and above, which is fair enough to get them reasonably good colleges. So that is our results in case of the CET. So let me tell you that what is the admission process. So what you need to do, so you need to collect the admission form from schools, and for the admission process and the fee details, everything will be given, every detail will be given by the school only. So our job is just to teach you. So rest of the operations is going to be taken care by school only. So that is the things from my side. You can note down this number. So this number is of our students counselor, Namrata Kalekar. She is also in the session right now. So the parents can ask academy related query. So once again, I'm telling that the fees related things and other operational related things, all those things you will be getting from the school only. But as far as the curriculum related, if you have any query, then definitely you can get in touch with Namrata Kalekar. So that's all what I have to say as far as the presentation on behalf of D.Y. Patil Academy is concerned. Now I just open this webinar for the parents. So if you have the questions, then it will be my privilege to answer all those questions. And let me add over here that my academic team is also there. So that is also present. So if you have any subject related queries, right? And suppose if any student want to know how to prepare any particular subjects, if you have that query, then definitely we will also answer those things. Over to the parents.
Parents or students, if you have any doubt, you can ask. We have a very renowned person with us. The faculty members are there. So it's a request from my side. So if any query you have, you can put forward to sir and the team.
Good morning, sir. Sir, I am Dishan from grade 11 science. I wish to appear for NEET and I want to ask about physics and chemistry, how to prepare for NEET regarding two subjects.
Dishan, what about biology?
Biology, I guess I didn't saw someone who teaches biology in this session, I guess. So.
No, actually it is me who teach biology.
Oh, sorry, sir. Yes, sir. So you
can. Okay, no problem. You see, let me answer this part. You see, first of all, I'm sure all of you know that 720 marks, right? 50% is a biology. Okay. So altogether 180 questions, 90 questions is biology, 45 is a physics, 45 is a chemistry. That is asked. Okay. Now, whosoever is preparing for NEET, listen carefully. If you want to qualify, you have to score 300 plus in biology. I repeat, 300 plus out of 360. Then only you have a chance. Otherwise, you don't have any chance. Right? Now, the second question is scoring 360 plus is a difficult task? My answer is very simple task. Very, very simple task. Right? So you have to stick to one point. And that one point is that stick to NCERT textbook. Once again, I'm repeating, stick to NCERT textbook. So there are two subjects in which the questions are never asked beyond NCERT textbook. One, the biology, and second, chemistry. So these are the two subjects in which you need to be very, very precise as far as your preparation with respect to NCERT textbook is concerned, right? So I'm handing over mic to Rajkumar sir, so he's our physics mentor. So sir, over to you. So please guide him regarding the physics.
Hello. Good morning, everybody. Myself Rajkumar Singh, and thank you, sir. Dear parents and students, I want to say one thing regarding a NEET examination. Examination is not very difficult, but accuracy will be much higher. So you have to prepare each and everything from every corner of your syllabus. Especially NEET examination, you have to study NCERT book, okay, and classroom notes, they are sufficient. And regarding JEE, you need a better hard working and complex, you have to do complex numericals. Say, for example, you have to do S.C. Verma, okay? And most of the students, they have already heard this regarding this book. So, competition is something, a passion, and you have to work hard according to that. If you want a good engineering college or good medical college, you have to work very hard. And this is something required from you. So my suggestion is our DYP brand is will help you to achieve your dream. And that's much. Okay, thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Let me add over here. You see, any exam has a certain philosophy. You see, NEET exam and engineering exam also has a philosophy. I'm just sharing very interesting aspect. So what is the philosophy of NEET exam and engineering exam? You see, the syllabus for JEE and NEET is the same, right? Same physics, same chemistry, same mathematics. Of course, in case of engineering mathematics, there is a biology. But as far as the physics, chemistry syllabus is concerned, in case of engineering, as well as in case of medical syllabus is same. And irony is that even in both the syllabus is same. Then what was the use that government is taking another exam in addition to your board exam on the same syllabus? What was the use? So there must be certain philosophy. So that is why they are conducting two different exam, isn't it? You see, they are looking for such person who have an aptitude for engineering, who have an aptitude for medical. Now, what is the aptitude for medical? The aptitude for medical, that medical professionals are supposed to work within a known field. Let me exemplify. Suppose there is a person from, let it be say Africa, Australia, or America. If I open a stomach of all the three person, I will find liver at the same place. I will find pancreas at the same place. It's not that American is going to have a pancreas at left or we have a right. It's not like that. That means we are looking for some person who is going to work on the same philosophy, who are working on the same field, same area, known area, not unknown area. And that is why you see questions in NEET are asked from each chapter. None of the chapters are actually left. This is out of this philosophy, right? Questions are never asked in which a large amount of logical reasoning is required. As Rajkumar sir said, that for the IIT JEE, some complex problem is required. For NEET, not required, because this is against the philosophy. So that's why the question will never be asked in physics, which is going to have a complex problem. That is a simpler problem is going to ask in case of NEET. Okay. But on contrary, you talk about engineering. In case of engineering, what happens? Suppose an engineer or one engineer has made a bridge over Ganga. That is in Patna. I hail from that city. That's why I always take the example. Okay. So you see, if I ask the same engineer to make a river, to make a bridge over Gomti, so is it possible to apply the same principle what he has applied in Patna in Lucknow? Is it possible? No, not possible. That means engineers are supposed to work in unknown field. There is always going to have a challenge in front of them. They are supposed to work in the unknown field, right? That is the reason why JEE questions are never repeated. They are always new. Okay, NEET questions are repeated. JEE questions will never be repeated. That is out of that philosophy. So you need to understand the philosophy. Okay, once you are through the philosophy, preparation is very easy. So that's why I'm saying for NEET, you need to restrict yourself to the NCERT, right? One, of course, conceptual learning is very important because unfortunately, NCERT textbook is not very smooth in learning. That I agree. As a teacher, I can understand. But as a student, if a student take NCERT textbook and he say, okay, fine, monetize just one paragraph is over, then definitely this is not going to solve the problem. That I understand, right? But of course, the question will be not asked beyond the Monera protesta that is written over. That is for sure. Okay. So I hope your question is answered.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome, beta. Any more questions?
Good morning, sir. My name is Nikhil Tiwari, and I'm preparing for NDA. I want to know how can I prepare for maths.
Okay, good question with incorrect person. So Jagdish sir, please take it forward.
Hello. Thank you, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning, all of you. For mathematics, I want to tell something that you should be perfect about the formulas. Aapko sab formula aana chahiye. Okay. फॉर्मूले बेसिक फॉर्मूले बहुत सारे बच्चों को बेसिक फॉर्मूले नहीं याद होते हैं जो बेसिक अलजेब्रा के फॉर्मूले उसके बाद येलो में आएंगे आप लोग द 12 के फॉर्मूले यू शुड लर्न ऑल द फॉर्मूले फ्रॉम ट्रिग्नोमेट्री ट्रिग्नोमेट्री के फॉर्मूले बिल्कुल आपके यानी टिप ऑफ टंग चाहिए ट्रिग्नोमेट्री के फॉर्मूले और क्योंकि 11 12 में मैथ्स में इतने फॉर्मूले हैं नंबर ऑफ फॉर्मूलेज आर देयर नियर अबाउट 300 फॉर्मूलेज आर देयर 300 formulas, एक formula आप learn करेंगे तो आप mathematics study easily कर सकते हैं दूसरी बात जो है आपके tables याद होना चाहिए tables at least 25th का table आपको यानी from 2 to 25th ये सब table आपको आना चाहिए then also you should know the Pythagoras triplet means you know a square plus b square is equal to c square Pythagoras triplet for example 3 4 5 this is Pythagoras triplet Okay, then 5, 12, 13, these are also Pythagoras triplet. To solve the problems very quickly, at least 10 to 15 Pythagoras triplet should know. You should know here. Okay, that increases to solve the problems. ये तो दो बात हो गई, तो तीन बात बताया मैंने. एक आपको फॉर्मूले ठीक ढंग से याद होना चाहिए. सेकेंडली आपके बेसिक्स क्लियर होना चाहिए, ज्योमेट्रिकल बेसिक्स, अल्जेब्रिक जो फॉर्मूले अल्जेब्रा के फंडामेंट्स वो क्लियर होना चाहिए. थर्ड मैंने बताया कि आपको ट्रिपलेट्स आना चाहिए, ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक के वैल्यूज आना चाहिए, जैसे साइन 180, साइन 180 क्या रहता है, साइन 180 जीरो मीन साइन पाए, साइन 2 पाए, साइन 3 पाए, साइन 4 पाए, ये सब वैल्यू जीरो रहते हैं. ओके, एनी इंटीजर मल्टीपल ऑफ पाए द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन इज जीरो. कॉस पाए, कॉस 2 पाए, ये वैल्यूज क्या रहते हैं, उसको थोड़ा प्रोसेस रहते लर्निंग के. ओके, कॉस पाए, कॉस 3 पाए, अगर ऑड मल्टीपल है, पाए का ऑड मल्टीपल है, कॉस पाए, कॉस 3 पाए, कॉस 5 पाए, कॉस 7 पाए, ये सब वैल्यूज माइनस 1 रहते हैं. अगर इवन मल्टीपल है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल कॉस 2 पाए, कॉस 4 पाए, कॉस 6 पाए, ये सब वैल्यूज प्लस 1 रहते. इफ यू रिमेंबर इन दिस वे, ओके, ऑल द वैल्यूज फ्रॉम 0 टू 360 डिग्री, ऑल्सो फॉर 30 डिग्री, 150 डिग्री, 120 डिग्री, 135, 225, ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, एटलीस्ट साइन कॉस. इफ यू नो एटलीस्ट साइन कॉस, देन यू कैन फाइंड ऑल द वैल्यूज. नाउ दैट मीन्स यू कैन इंक्रीज द टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स, योर स्पीड, स्पीड आपकी बढ़ जाएंगे, और स्पीड ही इंपॉर्टेंट है, क्योंकि जे में जो 25 क्वेश्चंस रहते हैं, इसमें 25 क्वेश्चंस, 25 में से अपने आप अगर 10-15 भी कर लिए प्रॉब्लम्स, तो फिजिक्स और केमिस्ट्री आप आसानी से कर सकते हो. मैथमेटिक्स जे में सबसे टफ रहता है, और अगर 10-15 अगर क्वेश्चंस कर लिए तो आप फिजिक्स और केमिस्ट्री उसमें थोड़ा सा इजी है एज कम्पेयर टू दिस टू सब्जेक्ट्स. तो आप आसानी से क्वालिफाई, यू गेट द मोर देन 95%, तो आपको एनआईटी में सक्सेस होने का चांसेस भी ज्यादा है. और मैं कुछ टिप्स जो दिया मैंने, आप दो बुक्स, दो रजिस्टर बना लो. एक तो एक रजिस्टर में आप सबके फॉर्मूले कलेक्ट करो, और दूसरे रजिस्टर में जो टिप्स रहते हैं, ओके, टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स जो क्लास में टीचर्स देते रहते हैं, जैसे मैं लिख के देता हूँ बुधवार, ये सब प्रॉपर्टीज क्या क्या है, सब ये सब अगर इकट्ठा जमा कर दिए, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वी कैन सक्सेस इन मैथमेटिक्स. ओके, थैंक यू. Thank you, sir.
Well, I have one query from one parent. She is Namrata Saxena. So she wants to know about biology. I hope she is a student, right? So Namrata, are you there?
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. So her question is that she wants to know that biology is very vast. So how to learn biology? Okay. Namrata, the first answer is biology is not vast. So this is the first answer, right? So why biology is tough? What is the reason behind the biology being tough? The reason is that students often get confused among the scientific names, that we have to learn so much scientific names, stuff like that, right? So my dear young friends, you see, very, very few questions are asked based on scientific names, very, very few questions. So it is very important to know that what is actually asked, what is not asked, what is important, what is not important. And I always say, zyada jaruri ye janna hai ki hume kya nahi padhna. That is the most important. Okay, padhai to karni hai. But the most important thing is that we need to understand that what not to read. Because I have seen in my career that most of the students end up learning more, which is actually not required. So better keep focus what is actually being required. So I told you one thing, that don't get entangled in this scientific names, because actually it creates a problem. Concentrate on the conceptual learning, particularly the molecular biology, जो कि आपके class 12 में आएगा. In class 11, you have a plant physiology, animal physiology, right? So these two are most important topic in which that need to be understand, right? And there is a one technique which, of course, I will speak here, and that is the mind mapping. So I have written as many as 30 books on mind maps. So mind maps is one of the best technique to memorize it. To keep the things for longer duration of time. Okay. So actually, I don't want to just advertise or talk about my books, but these books are available on Amazon. So if you want, you can purchase. So either on Amazon, on the Flipkart, the search box, you simply type Mind Map Biology, you will get my books. So you can get those books. So that will help you in preparing the things and in keeping the things for a longer duration in your brain. So that is the most important thing that you can do. Okay. So Namrata, I hope you got my, you got the answers. If you have any query, please go ahead. So there is a one more question. Is there any reference book is needed for biology? So yes, of course, one reference book is needed for biology, right? I've always said that the NCERT book should be the core. As far as the reference book is concerned, if you are enrolled in our program, then I say don't take reference book. Our study material is enough. That is going to take care of the reference book. If you're not enrolling in the program, then definitely you take any one reference book. I don't recommend any name. The reason being that you select a reference book in which the number of pages are very less. I repeat, aise reference book ko select karo jisme number of pages bahut kam ho. Zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi. Right? Because you see, I have seen lot of books, lot of voluminous books in which unnecessary, irrelevant information are given, which is actually not required for the need. Stick to NCERT textbook for conceptual things. Definitely, you need a reference book. So take a reference book. If you are purchasing any book from the market, right? Of course, last but not the least, I will certainly talk about the mind mapping books. You get the mind map books from the online things, that is Amazon or Flipkart, you can get it. Any more questions?
Sir, how can we memorize physics?
Oh, physics cannot be memorized. Physics can be understood. So physics, you need to understand. You see, biology also you need to understand. It's not a question of memorization. You see, what we memorize the sequences. Okay. So suppose if the starting point is actually in your mind, then by mind mapping, you can build a sequence in your brain. But in case of physics, in some chapters it can be done, but for entire physics it cannot be done. Okay, so for physics you need to learn. Raj sir, aap kuch bolenge kya?
Yes sir, thank you. Actually, the problem is regarding physics. Most of the students, they are facing problem that theory they can easily understand, but wide-linked problems or numericals, it is very difficult to just, they are facing difficulties. So my advice is, there are some certain steps while doing numericals. Steps are, step number one, first of all, you have to understand all the classroom notes and theory part. Step number two, you have to learn the formulas. Step number three, then you have to go for little bit easy problem, or you can say little easy problem or solved problems. Then after solved problem and easy problem, then you have to switch for average and higher problems. So while doing problems, when you engage yourself in doing numericals, you will gain confidence. Then you will gain confidence. Unless and until you will not try problems, you are not able to understand physics. Because ek baar theek hai, formulae samajh mein aa gaye, theory samajh mein aa gayi. Jab problems karte hai na, to more new things you will learn. So these are the steps you have to follow. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We have another question. Is NEET or JEE compulsory for B pharmacy or D pharmacy? Certainly not. So B pharmacy, there is a separate exam. I told you that CET is a one exam through which you can go for the B pharmacy as well as the D pharmacy, right? Any more questions?
If there are no more questions, we can go ahead with the session. Preeta, I request you to continue.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, sir, for enriching us with your presence and wise words. which shall magnify us all in the best possible way. Now I call upon Namrata, Renaissance, and Joelia to share about their experience on today's session.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank all the counselors and mentors for organizing this webinar. It was very useful for all of us and with their best explanations. Thank you so much, sir, for guiding us.
Good morning, sir. It was a really great, excellent session. By seeing, we get to know more about how to apply for competitive exams. It makes us much easier to know about which courses is best for us. We really want to say a big thank you.
Thank you, Beta.
On behalf of DPVN School and entire fraternity, first of all, my sincere thanks to Almighty God for making today's event a grand success. I give a really heartfelt vote of thanks to our principal, Ms. Ashu Rana Ma'am, for arranging the session for us. I give a heartfelt vote of thanks to our speaker, Dr. Pankaj Kumar Sir, who spent his busiest gracing the occasion. Today we had the opportunity to hear the thoughts, and this is definitely encouraging us in our future. Our thoughts have enlightened our minds and shown us a new path. A big thank you to all the faculty members of D.Y. Patil Academy, Pune, for making the event a success one. Last but not least, I thank all the parents and my friends for taking your time and attending the session. Thank you.
Thank you.
On behalf of DPVN School, sincere thanks to Dr. Pankaj Kumar Sir for giving your time and spending your valuable thoughts with all our students and parents. I am sure we all look forward to join your academy and hoping for the best to come for our students. Thank you, sir, and thank you all the faculty members. Thank you all the team who worked for this beautiful session we had today. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.